And who knows for how long. Nobody said a word. The fact that Sayaka and Junko were dead was a huge shock, of course. But there was more to it than that. I need to adjust this. Hold up. Okay. Alright. But there was more to it than that. There was also the idea that one of us had actually murdered someone. And that if we didn't find out who it was, we would all die here. Hey, I got two hosts. Auto hosts. But still, a host is a host. TY guys. Anyways, we'd found ourselves in a situation where we couldn't help but look at each other with open suspicion. Hi Mel, how you doing? It was the worst situation imaginable. And yet, even in such a perversely terrible situation, she didn't show the slightest hint that it had gotten to her.
Hey.
You sleepy? Let my
great commentary
wake you up. Now's no time to wallow in your depression. The worst thing we can do right now is lose all faith in each other. That would lead to the same disastrous result as having total faith in everyone else.
What?
Huh?
In other words,
cooperation is absolutely key at this point. Who you decide to trust or not trust is, of course, up to you. Yeah. Wait, come. Don't worry, Mel. At least you got up. And, yeah, I'm at the first two deaths. An investigation part, yeah. Like, I got to it at the end of the stream yesterday. After 4 hours, and now I'm actually at the action. Continuing to think about and talk about the deceased certainly isn't going to help anything.
What the heck?
Saying stuff like that is just... How many times have I told you? Anyone who can't adapt will die. Death is the only thing awaiting those who are unable or unwilling to adapt. Dude, the art in this game is so sick. But anyway, if that happens, you only have yourself to blame.
That's terrible!
One awful thing to say, especially after what's happened.
Just a second.
Right now, exposing the killer is the most important thing, because if we don't, we're all going to die here.
Yugi, she's right. We need to begin our search right away.
Of course.
Oh, that's not Kyber enough. Anyways,
either way, we can't run away from the situation, so we have no choice but to move forward.
What the heck?
We just have to do it, I guess. What other choice do we have? No way in hell am I letting someone kill me. Alright, damn it, let's do this! We just have to do it. Everyone kept repeating that sentiment. They were using it like a mantra to give themselves strength. But they were right. We just have to do this. No matter how much we don't want to. We have no choice. If that's what it takes to survive, then that's what we have to do. On top of that, there was something I needed to find out. I had to know why Sayaka had to die. Why she had to be the one. I'm terrified to find out, but still, I have to know. Otherwise, I'd never be able to accept her death. Which is why I don't have any choice. I have to do this!
Yeah, as well.
Gather information. Before we start searching for Sayaka's killer, we need to decide what to do about securing the crime scene. But I still need to... I've got my stream, my Discord link in the I need to... I don't know, man. It always annoys me whenever I see a Nightbot being like, hey, my Discord, but whatever. Anyway. Yeah. What do you mean?
You're thinking of putting someone on guard duty, so no one can disturb the area, aren't you? After all, if the opponent decides to destroy the evidence, we're pretty much screwed.
Hey.
In that case, I don't mind doing it. I don't like having to think, anyway. I'll let you guys figure out who killed that chick. Okay, then we can let Mondo look after the scene.
Well, no. We can't just leave him there alone.
What?
What? Why the hell not?
Stop talking.
Isn't it obvious? If you were the culprit, what's the first thing you would do? By volunteering for guard duty, you're in a position to destroy all the evidence you want. What? Fuck you!
So then.
Fine, then I'll stay there on guard duty as well. That way there's no problem.
Mm-hmm. Two-player co-op based defense with the two of them. With their stats, they're totally OP.
Since we won't be able to help investigate, we're putting our faith in the rest of you.
I'm still pretty freaked out, but I'll try. Why am I starting to do voice? Alright, cool. So, Kaiba, what are you gonna do?
We need to hurry up and figure out who the culprit is.
Okay, cool. So I'm guessing everyone's just gonna have meaningless, like, talk like that as well. If we find out who did it, then only that person dies. But if we get it wrong, then the rest of us all face the execution. That's what that ridiculous school regulation said, right? So stupid. Alright, so yeah, let me just look at the body real quick. I gently placed my hand on Junko's lifeless body. I touched her wrist to check for a pulse, like they do in movies and stuff, but... She dead, boy. She really is dead. There wasn't anything else to say. She was gone.
I don't know why you even bothered to check. After those injuries and losing that much blood. Frankly, I'd be shocked if she did survive something like that.
Huh? Hold on. Just wait a second. She's dead? Then that means... That means everything that's happened so far is real? It's not a joke or whatever? It's really real? Come on, dude. Hell no! Someone save me! Let me out! Well, he said that anyway. Somebody help me!
What's your problem?
You're just now accepting that? Good point. Alright, I'm moving.
Just a second.
Hold on. Okay. Huh? Before we begin the investigation, isn't there something else we need to discuss? Oh, yeah. Right, you have more things to say?
Anyway.
We're going to... I didn't mean to press that, but... Come on, man, let me out of here. Come on, bruh, like... What else do we need to discuss? Ifumi, consciousness is crashed. Restart. Okay.
What should I do?
Someone got right. Yes, they did. I'm gonna just... Can't run away from the situation. Yeah.
What the heck?
Uh-huh.
Oh.
So you finally noticed. Huh? Notice what? I was looking through the Monokuma file we received, and I noticed something very obvious and very unusual. Oh wait, hold up. No, that's not it. Right, let me just... Can I just open up... No. Where's the Monokuma file? How do I access that? Hold on. One second. Where is this? How do I access this file? Okay, so I can't access it yet. I had to talk to her to do it. Alright, cool. Well. Go ahead, take a look. Notice anything interesting about where Sayaka died? She died in Makoto's dorm. What? She's right! Then could it be? All at once, everyone's gaze turned to me. Hold on a second! You've got it all wrong! Just one night, I traded rooms with her. I did it because she was afraid. You expect us to believe that? Just tell us the truth! The look in everyone's eyes had done a complete 180 from just a few minutes earlier. The feeling of suspicion and fear had returned. In other words, you think I did it? You just gotta investigate, bro. Are we all done talking? We need to begin our investigation soon. At this point, we should split up. We need to get to the bottom of this and find out who killed Sayaka. Public enemy number one. I know, right? I gotta clear my name. Give me a chance, boys. Come on. We'll have to collect clues from to form a foundation, and then construct an argument to come to a final decision. My gosh, if you get this wrong, well, do I really have to say this anymore? Oh my god. I'd rather you
didn't know.
Goodbye.
Everyone pray for good luck. Goodbye. With that, Kyoko hurried out of the gym.
Goodbye. I'll be going too.
And just like Kyoko, he was gone before we realized it.
Yo.
Oh yeah, I'm on guard duty, huh? I better head to the scene of the crime. That's right.
Hey, damn it.
Let me just say this right now. If whatever son of a bitch did this is right here, Oh my god. If whatever son of a bitch did this is here right now, and they're thinking of destroying that evidence,
you're fucking dead.
They better not let me find them. I'll skip the trial and cave their goddamn skull in myself. I'm serious. I will fuck them up.
Letting his deadly words hang in the air, he and Sakura ran off. But I mean, we're not detectives or anything, you know? We're gonna investigate the murder? I'm an ace attorney, what are you on about? How do we even do something like that?
Anyway,
we don't really have to do anything particular. We already know who killed Sayaka. What are you implying? It was you.
Suspicious.
I'm telling you, it wasn't me. Don't come any closer. Are you gonna kill me next? Well, I guess it wouldn't hurt to give it a shot. It's not for sure that Makoto's guilty yet.
That's true. We may as well at least check.
Yes. Even if I wanted to, I couldn't help investigate.
Aww.
Wait, why not? I'm not good with blood. All it takes is one glimpse and I black out.
Oh yeah?
Well, whatever. I don't think anyone was expecting much from you anyway. Oh jeez. Savage, man. Yo, chill. Alright, I guess I better get going. Wait, don't go yet. You have to hear me out. But it was pointless. Everyone had already left. Do all your explanations in the trial, Makoto. Can't wait for the trial, man. Oh my gosh. Anyways, and their parting looks at me had still been filled with suspicion. Does everyone really think I'm the killer? How did it turn out like this? Seriously, they've got it all wrong. Why do they have to suspect me? I have to do something. Otherwise, everyone will.
Execution is execution. Execution! Electric chair! Poison gas! Torn apart like a paper plane in a hurricane!
I can't let that happen. I can't let things turn out the way Monokuma wants! All I have to do is find out who really did it. Who really killed Sayaka? Finally. I guess I should look through the Monokuma file we got before. The victim was Sayaka Maizono. The time of death is estimated to be around 1:30 a.m. The body was discovered in Makoto's room in the dormitory. All evidence suggested the death took place in the bathroom. The cause of death was a stab wound to the abdomen. There was also an injury to her right wrist. Specifically, the wrist appears to have suffered a fracture. We have no choice but to push forward if we want to find out what happened. Somehow, I have to find out the truth, so that we can all survive. And for Sayaka. I have to find out how she was killed. Nice! Monokuma file 1. Nice. Let me just check that out myself. If that's actually... Okay, so it was literally... Alright, cool. Let us leave. I have to check out the crime scene after all. Yes. so I headed to my room where Sayaka's corpse still remained. I better examine the state of my room a little closer. That might reveal something new. Yeah, you don't have to tell me twice. This is the replica sword I brought back for self-defense. Is there any gold missing? Does this mean it was used in the attack somehow? And plus, it's been taken out of its sheath. I hadn't actually looked at the blade itself till now. I shouldn't be surprised it's coated in gold too. On top of that, some of the gold coating has come off of parts of the blade and the handle. Yes. Yeah, the handle especially has a lot of is missing a lot of its coating. I remember the coating sticks to you even if you just touch it a little bit. Mm-hmm. More evidence. For the court record. There's a key on the ground. It has my name on it, so this must be my room key. If I remember correctly. Ah, that's right, we'll have to trade keys. Yes, she had your key. And we switched rooms, we switched keys too. So Sayaka would have had the key here in my room the entire time. But wait, if that's true then, how did the killer get into the room in the first place? Could Sayaka have forgotten to lock the door? She probably just invited them in. No, that seems impossible. The same goes for you, Sayaka. No matter who it is, don't open your door for anyone. Even if I'm sure it's you, absolutely won't open it. Otherwise, what's the point of even switching? After saying that, there's no way she would have forgotten to lock it, or opened it for any reason. Well, maybe she dropped the key somewhere, and someone else grabbed it or something. No, that's not possible either. Sayaka was in here when we switched rooms, and with how scared she was, she wouldn't have gone walking around. So she couldn't have dropped it. So, how did the killer? I'm just thinking, sorry. So like, either she did actually forget to lock it, which I'm pretty sure wasn't the case, but we didn't really check that still. Or she somehow just invited someone in, but that also wouldn't, it's also a strange one, isn't it? The notepad is still here, but yeah, sorry, my bad. Look at the bed. The gouge is in the bed. That's how you say it, right? Gouge? like someone attacked it. What the hell happened here? Scenes of a struggle. There are scratches and gouges on my walls and bed. Is that evidence of a struggle? Yes. It looks like there must have been some kind of fight in my room. Damn it! I was right there in the other room. If only I'd heard something, but the rooms are soundproof.
That would not have been possible.
Huh?
Don't you remember? All of our rooms are completely soundproof. Something could happen in the room right next to you, and there's no way you could know.
I was just thinking just now, like, what if you murder someone in your own bathroom and then no one would be able to get into it, especially if you're a girl? But then, like, if everybody would notice that someone's missing, and then they'd probably be like, we'll have to check everyone's rooms at some point, and then you'd be found out. So, yeah, no way. Click on everything you think you need to. Oh, yeah, true. Yeah, I guess it's the same like that in the Ace Attorney games, too. You just gotta, like, there's been times where I've, like, skipped over, like, a piece of evidence I thought wasn't, like, relevant. And then it's like some kind of like rock on the ground. I'm like, eh, no, don't need to look at that. But then like you actually needed to. So yeah, I'll be doing that stuff.
Well, perhaps this is another one of Monokuma's strategies, creating an ideal setting for murder.
Probably is. You know, not gonna lie. All right, struggle. Tip. I do not want to talk to you. Okay, Sakura, do you think I'm guilty too?
Hey.
I try not to make assumptions like that. I simply don't know whether or not you did this. Whatever decision the rest of you come up with, I will follow your lead.
I see. Can I look at the table? No. Can't look at the bin. I guess that's just all part of the thing. Let's look inside the desk. The The toolkit is still inside the drawer. I don't see any evidence that it's been used at all. Which makes sense, I guess. I mean, it's mine and I haven't had any reason to open it. I can't even imagine a situation where I need a toolkit like this.
Yo.
Yeah, seriously. Oh, Mondo.
What?
We ain't exactly in the mood to be building fucking furniture, right? So you haven't used yours either then. You haven't used yours either then. Oh my god. Dude. The Ace Attorney games are so good. If you like Danganronpa, I think you'll like the Ace Attorney games as well. Like, they're so good. They've got like a bunch of interesting characters as well. And like, sometimes you really do just get stumped within like trials and stuff. And you're trying to find like contradictions and stuff. And the music and the soundtrack is just so nice. Oh my gosh, they really outdid themselves in that game. Capcom, man. I played every single Ace Attorney game that's ever come out. I love it that much. Anyway.
Why?
Not just me. Why? Nobody's busted theirs out yet, as far as I know. Actually, we were talking about it yesterday.
By the way,
none of the guys have opened their toolkits yet. Cause like, why the hell would you? Yeah, true. Why the hell would you? It's true. Should we look at the ones on the wall? There are scratches and gouges on my walls and bed. Okay. Cool.
Well.
Yeah. Can I look at the sheath, or is that just gonna look at the ground again? Yeah. Oh, okay, huh? There's some scratches on the sheath. It must have been made of something sharp. But how'd the sheath get scratched up in the first place? Even if someone used a sword during the struggle, it doesn't make sense for the sheath to be damaged. I mean, if you're gonna attack someone with a sword, the first thing you'd do is unsheath it. A heavy sheath like this would only get in the way. It could just slide off in the middle of the fight. So why are there scratches on the sheath? Either they didn't have enough time to shield themselves with the sheath, or get the sword out of the sheath so they had to shield themselves with it, or the attacker took out the sword out of the sheath, and then attacked the other person who had to use a sheath as a shield. Something like that. That's all I'm thinking. Oh, Kyoko! What do you think? Hey, Kyoko. I quietly called her name while she was investigating the area, but ignored.
What are you doing? Isn't it obvious? No. I'm searching.
Oh.
Searching?
She was down on her knees, carefully inspecting every inch of my room.
Did you lose a contact or something?
I don't know what she's doing exactly, but she seems to be concentrating pretty hard on it. Alright, bathroom. I should look around here first. What the hell? Okay, I haven't looked at everything, I guess. I've already looked at the bed. Anything? I shall talk to Mondo.
By the way,
you know, I realized something while I was on guard duty. The critter could have already destroyed some evidence, right? Before anybody found the body, I mean. There's a trash room here in the dorms, right? They could have tossed some stuff in there. That's good, that's true. Yeah, that's definitely possible.
You son of a bitch!
That dirty bastard! anyone who raises their hand to a woman is scum that deserves death. That's what my brother taught me.
You're fucking dead.
So if I ever find the son of a bitch that did this, I'm gonna pound his goddamn face in. But what if it was a girl that did it?
Yo.
That'll all get sorted out when the time comes. Alright. My man Mondo, I didn't mean to click this. Yep. I wanted to look at the TV. This is one of the monitors Monokuma appears on right now. Okay, cool. How about the camera? Oh no, sorry, the lint roller. My bad. Huh? Looking at the lint roller, it looks like there's way less than there was before. Did Sayaka see how dirty my room was and decide to clean up a little? But your room wasn't dirty, dude. They probably use that to get rid of the gold off their hands, maybe? I don't know. But then wouldn't there be evidence of the gold on another roller? A surveillance camera. The mastermind, yes. Yes. Alright. What was that? I've looked up. Look at those. Look at that, look at that. Fam, I feel like I've... Oh yeah, okay. It's a display stand the sword was on. Right. I'm gonna see if I can go in again, and if he... No. Okay. The table. Can I actually look at the table now? No.
Well.
I. Okay.
By the way, you son of...
Mads called for me in stream. Try talking to you. Alright. Hey, Kyoko. I quietly, yes, but...
What are you doing? Isn't it obvious?
No. Not really.
I'm searching.
Searching? Did you lose a contact or something?
But a few seconds later, she suddenly stood up straight and said, "Wow."
Listen.
Are you a clean freak? Huh? No, I don't think so, but... What? Nodding, she glanced around my room once, one more time.
I see.
Interesting. What's interesting?
Hey.
Just as I suspected, there's something very unusual about your room. Reaction! What's very unusual? Oh! I've searched your floor from one corner to another, and I didn't find one single strand of hair. Really?
Indeed.
Not one hair from the victim, and not one hair from you, even though you've been living in here. You know, now that you mention it, I noticed something while I was looking around before. It looked like the lint roll in my room had been used, but I never touched it. Could someone have used it to...
I see.
Very interesting. Your room didn't have a single hair in it, and someone used your lint roll without your knowledge. In other words, someone other than you came in and scrubbed your room clean. Was it Sayaka? Or the killer?
Well,
that's the question, isn't it? There we go. Thank you very much, Kuro. Now can I go back in? Can I go in now, please? Oh, thank you. The bathroom along the other side of this door. Oof. No, I can't let it get to me. I can't afford to freeze up now. Forcing myself to push my panic down, I stepped into the bathroom. Dang. Looking at her made it painfully clear it wasn't a dream or an illusion. She had lost everything that made her, her. Sayaka. All at once I was overcome with dizziness, nausea, and the urge to burst into tears. But I can't. I can't hesitate now. Why? Why did Sayaka have to die? I have to uncover the truth. I had to find out what happened. I wanted to give up. I wanted to collapse. But that thought held me up and supported me. Alright, let's look at the body. I told myself I simply couldn't face what I saw, but now's no time to think like that. I pulled out the Monokuma file to verify what it said about her body. Some sort of sharp object has been thrust into her stomach. That must have been the killing blow. But whatever they used to kill her, where'd they get it? That's definitely something I should look into later. Yeah, we'll go to the kitchen. According to the Monokuma file, Sayaka's right wrist is broken. Her wrist does look swollen and bloody, that's for sure. But there's something sort of glittery on there on her wrist too, so she used a sword. Right there, where her wrist is all swollen. There's something glittery. Either she used a sword or someone smacked her wrist with the sword. That definitely concerns me. Another thing that concerns me is... Huh? There's some blood on her left index finger, but that's it. The palms of both of her hands are totally spotless, so how come only her left finger? Oh, because there's a shining message or dying message right behind her. You can see, like, letters. The stab wound in her stomach is what killed her. So when she broke her wrist, that must have happened earlier on. I mean, how would her wrist get broken after she'd already been killed? So it's very possible she broke her wrist during the struggle. The killer attacked Sayaka in the main room, which is when her wrist got broken. After that, the killer cornered her in the bathroom, where they inflicted the deadly wound. Can we look at this? I'm glad you're enjoying it, Kuro. That pink blood. Why do you... Having pink blood? I mean... No? I wish... I mean, my blood is red. I've seen it before. I don't want to have pink blood. That'd be weird, man. And I'm pretty sure the pink blood is just a censorship with quotation marks. I looked past Sayaka to the wall behind her. And there I saw... Leon. Huh? What? Written in blood were the numbers 11037. Are you kidding me, dude? That clearly says Leon. Did Sayaka do this? Please don't act like an idiot, please. That clearly says Leon, bro. Come on, man. Come on, bro. For goodness sake. I can even see the little mark of, like, the N crossing the two ones, dude. Don't be an idiot. Come on, Makoto, come on, man. What else? I want to look at the sort of blood spot behind her, because it has, like, an interesting pattern, but oh well. Bruh, okay. Yeah, that was duck ass, as I thought. Kinda wanna look around the bathroom a bit more. So that's where the shower is, huh? Just open? Or does it slide up? Who knows? Oh, okay, I see. So they have a thing that separates the toilet and the shower. That's pretty interesting. So the shower's just really spacious and open. That's pretty cool. Anyway. Yeah. Dash, why did you do it, man? We know it was you. Yeah, come on, bro. Don't act like you don't know what you did. You had to do that much DPS, huh? It looks like you found it, right, Makoto? The bloody numbers. That's most likely Sayaka's dying message. Bloody numbers. Never seen something written in blood before. It really was her final message. It's as if she wrote it with life herself. Right. Itself. Oh my gosh. Do you often talk like an aspiring poet? But the numbers she wrote, what do they mean? 11037. I have no idea what that could possibly mean.
So...
The way she wrote the numbers makes me think she wanted to use her body to block them. If she wrote them in that location while she was sitting the way we found her. Wait, was the blood on her... He said the palms were spotless. Was the blood on her right finger or her left? Yeah. It means she must have wrote them by only turning her hand toward the wall. Yeah. If you had to write something in that position, do you know what the result would be? Obviously, it'd be...
Well?
The result? Think about it. You're not gonna tell me? You need to uncover the mystery of this case yourself. Otherwise, the case will end and you'll remain unconvinced. I have no idea what you're trying to say, but it's obviously not gonna tell me. Bro. It sounds like Kyoko knows what Sayaka's dying message means. But honestly, I have no idea. Oh, I know who I should talk to. When it comes to numbers, who better to ask than the ultimate programmer? There's one other thing I wanted to ask you about. Do you know how the door to your bathroom got broken? Broken? Oh, you mean how it gets stuck?
What?
Gets stuck? Yeah, I guess I'm the only one, but the door doesn't fit in the frame quite right. When I first tried to use it, I thought it was just locked. But once you learn the trick, it opens no problem. Bathroom door frame has been added to the yes.
Correct.
Yes. So the door doesn't quite fit the frame, huh? But actually, I'm referring to the broken doorknob. Oh. The doorknob.
That's right.
You didn't notice? Well, just try closing the bathroom door. I'm sure you'll see right away what I'm talking about. I did what Kyoko said and shut the bathroom door. Huh? The doorknob. It's twisted and bent, which means Sayaka is not the one who opened the door. What the heck? Oh, on the left index finger, her right was fractured. Alright, cool, thanks. Nana, you did all the DPS on this monster. No, Dash, I got my DPS chart open. It said 100% of the damage is you, bro. What the heck? The doorknob's practically about to fall off. Why is it like this?
It would seem...
Someone must have used a screwdriver or something similar to unscrew it. Whatever it was, it's obvious this was intentional. What? It was intentional? Why would someone want to do that?
So...
I guess maybe they're trying to get the door unlocked and they ended up breaking the whole thing. But my bathroom doesn't have a lock on it. Only the girls' bathrooms can lock, right? She stood there for a while, lost in thought. Then, apparently struck with a sudden realization, she shot a question at me.
Just a second.
I have just one more question for you. You mentioned earlier that your bathroom door would get stuck, right?
Yes.
Did you tell anyone about that?
Only Sayaka.
Well, I did tell Sayaka about it last night when we switched rooms. So what you're saying is, only you and Sayaka knew about
mm-hmm.
it. Hmm. Interesting. She had the slightest hint of a smirk on her face. I got the sense that she was really starting to get into all this. Then that clears that up. Huh? What clears what up? I'm so lost. Well, see you later. Yeah, peace. As if forgetting I was ever even there, she suddenly turned and left the room.
Nice!
I still don't really understand any of this, but... I've already given my room a good once over. Maybe I should look around somewhere else. I should start looking into where the murder weapon might have come from. And also, I should look into the DVD Sayaka got. With Sayaka dead, I have no choice but to see for myself what was in that video. And on top of that, I'm sure there are some other areas where... checking out too. Maybe I should see what everyone else thinks, if they'll even talk to me, that is. Right, so, okay. Next place shall be the kitchen. There's gotta be a knife missing, right? Hello, Asahina. I'm gonna go into the kitchen. And as I thought, there's one knife missing. So now we know where the murder weapon came from. That's strange. How could they have got the murder weapon at 1:30 when the canteen is closed? Okay, so seeing as the numbers did say Leon, must have been Leon who, oh, I don't know, the killer must have gotten the knife in the kitchen before it closed, and somehow hid the fact that they had it. Anyway, there are all kinds of kitchen knives here, big to small, but it looks like one of them is missing. Was it missing from the very beginning, or no, it wasn't. I better see if anyone here knows more about it. So, kitchen knife set. So now I go and talk to Asahina, who I believe used the kitchen the most. And then she'll tell me that there was always a full set of knives. There's like 3 pieces of damning evidence for this trial. Oh yeah. Is that what happened? I'm pretty sure that is what happened. Well, it's gotta be. You can only get the knife in daytime. Hey, so, did you notice that one of the kitchen knives is missing from the dining hall?
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, weird, huh? I thought it was kind of strange. A knife just suddenly disappearing like that? Oh, so it wasn't missing from the beginning?
That's right.
Nope. Last I remember, they're all lined up in a nice, neat row. Oh, so when did you notice one of them had disappeared?
Well,
when I went to get some tea from the kitchen last night, all the knives were still there. But when I finished my tea and went back to the kitchen to wash my glass, one of the knives was gone. So you're saying the knife disappeared while you were drinking your tea in the dining hall? Mm. Wait, what the fuck? So someone snuck around her? Question mark? Yeah. In other words, you're right there in the dining hall when someone came and took it. Then you should be able to say for sure. You can tell everyone I didn't come into the dining hall last night, which proves I didn't take it. Nice. I always account. Witness testimony. Anyways, hey, by the way, did you really kill Sayaka? What? Of course not. I would never. Hina, do you really think I murdered her? Well, she was killed in your room, right? So I mean, you guys were supposed to be friends, right? But you still killed her. On the other hand, two people becoming good friends is then one killing the other is a classic drama setup. So when you consider everything together, I honestly have no idea. Yeah, shut your mouth, mate. Kidding. Detective Chichikun Desio. More like Ace Attorney. Oh, I can strafe. Anyways. Ace Attorney Chichikun. Can I run a strafe as well? Oh my god, speedrunning. He wanted to talk to the detective chick. I remember, so. She's on the bottom floor. Can I teleport? I can. Hey Chihiro, I was hoping I could ask you something.
Huh?
Oh, what is it? Before she died, Sayaka left a message. Show out the numbers 11037. Do you have any idea what these numbers might mean? Like there could be a code or something? Sorry, no. Chihiro slowly shook her head.
I'm sorry.
I just don't know. Okay. Well, don't worry about it. Thanks anyway for trying. Even if she doesn't know. Or, could she maybe know more than she's letting on? No, couldn't be. Let's see if this guy's still freaking out. Yes, he is. Ugh, no way. I seriously don't want to die here.
Help me!
I'm begging you, God, Buddha, Mother of Earth, God of Space, King Neptune, help me. I don't care who it is, just get me out of here. Hero doesn't seem to be... doesn't seem prepared to do any kind of investigating right now. Of course. Everybody's favorite boy, Hagakure. Trash room. I did not need to look at that, but... it's always good to look at the court record, am I right? Number scratches. Okay, yeah. Right wrist, left wrist. Okay, cool. Makes sense. Because if it wasn't on her left, and it was on her right finger, it would mean she would have turned around and wrote the numbers. Also, it would be an awkward position trying to write the message, or Leon's name, on the left-hand side of her body with her right hand. But anyway, yeah, Leon. Dola. Some of the screws. We need to check everyone's toolkit. Maybe check the toolkit again. Anyway. I still see the dining hall. Yeah, I just need to TP somewhere, so. Ace Attorney Chipotle, what the flip? It's still locked. There's a soda gate here, no way to get past.
Monokuma appears!
It's the end of the line!
Monokuma.
The trash room. This is where all the trash in the school eventually winds up.
How'd you get this gate open? Yo, Monokuma, don't you wanna... Since you wound up here, does that mean you're trash too? That was a sick burn, right guys? Am I right? Why can't everyone just get along? Just get alone? How do you get this gate open?
No, you can't go any further!
No entry beyond this point! Only the person on cleaning duty is allowed in.
Cleaning duty?
No, you can't go any further!
Okay. Who's on cleaning duty?
You can't go any further!
Okay, yeah. This is stupid. It'd be faster to just go around and ask the others.
You can't go any further!
Okay. Nice. Anyway, look at that again. Looks like some kind of... Okay, yeah, whatever.
No, you can't go any further. No.
I don't want to talk to you. Well, I gotta find out who's on cleaning duty. I'm looking for whoever's on cleaning duty.
Cleaning duty? As a matter of fact, that's me. Why do you ask?
Oh, mad. Fine. Thanks, guys. Thanks for the support.
It just so happens Monokuma talked to me yesterday and asked me to take care of it. With someone on cleaning duty, the school would be flooded with trash in no time. So I formally applied for the position.
Oh, wow.
I was gonna start this morning, but after what happened, I haven't had a chance to get started.
Oh, wow. And since you're on cleaning duty, you can open the gate in front of the trash room?
Here we go.
Of course. It's my job to gather up all the garbage and toss it in the trash room. And to do that, they gave me the key for the trash room gate.
Mm-hmm. It's a pretty dumb... Yeah, I know, right? Like, you should be able to, like, find everything, but... You know, Monokuma's just a crafty guy, isn't it? Crafty little bear. But we're supposed to rotate once a week, so eventually you'll be in charge.
Very strange.
Wait, hold on. You need a key to get into the trash room? And only the person on cleaning duty has access to the key. But what's the point of going to all that trouble? Why not just leave the trash room open all the time, so we can all throw things out whenever we want?
That does seem more convenient.
So in other words...
Actually... Mokuba!
Anyone who kills a fellow student and comes black and will graduate, as they discovered, yeah?
So that's it.
That must be why. If anyone could go in and out of the trash room whenever they wanted, then destroying evidence would be easy. The thrill would disappear, and things would become boring.
But boring?
Hey, listen.
Anyway, more important than that.
Hey, you bastard.
Hey, fatty, why do you want the cleaning duty gig anyway?
I just decided to volunteer for something I knew no one else would want to do. What's the big deal?
You...
Liar. I know why you did it. Chill out, Leon. I know you're the killer, bro. Come on.
Is it like...
You want to dig through all the girls' trash? Looking for... You know, I'm poking around at it. You... Chill, guys.
There's no way to think about this in a common sense kind of way.
I'm on cleaning duty.
What are you talking about? All my love is for 2D.
D-gens. Just kidding. But there's all kind of trash diggers like that. Maybe you'll get tired of 2D and then turn to...
I would never get tired of 2D. After spending a significant amount of time comparing 2D and 3D, I voluntarily chose 2D. The only good thing 3D is for is to shower love and affection on 2D. Oh, and PVC figures.
Give me a break.
How are you not totally embarrassed to say stuff like that?
If you're so worried about Hifumi's unquestionable morality, there's a very easy solution. Whenever a guy has cleaning duty, Sakura can accompany them from picking up the trash to disposing of it.
What?
What?
If you're as innocent as you claim, where's the harm in it?
That's not how it's supposed to... Anyway, on another topic, Hifumi, since you're on cleaning duty... On cleaning duty... Well, I have a favor to ask you. Yo, dude, that's 100% staff, man. What? Now you suddenly want to join my party? Sorry, but you haven't triggered that flag yet. I mean, you haven't helped me recover from a past trauma, or save a village, or be the boss. No, nothing like that. I was just hoping to get into the trash room and look around. Oh, okay. So easy. So, Hifumi and I headed down to the trash room. You'd like me to open the gate, wouldn't you? You know, when I look at it, it makes me think. They said he killed his wife. He learned how to get by on the inside, but he never stopped dreaming. Get busy living or get busy dying, he said. So him and Rita, they found themselves a way out. Whatever, please just hurry up. Okie dokie, leave it to me. Hifumi pulled out a key out of his pocket and used it to flip the switch next to the gate. And then... Oh no, it can't go any further. However, Mr. Naegi, surely you aren't planning to use a trash room to destroy evidence, are you? You fiend! You planned this all along! No. I just wanted to see if the actual killer tried to destroy any evidence or not. But the actual killer is you, isn't it? You want to see if you left anything behind. Wait, maybe a parallel world? Bruh. Whatever, let's just hurry up and keep looking. Wait, let me switch the right stick, bam. And then we switch the left. Maybe I should play with the gamepad instead. Anyway. There are shards of broken glass scattered around in front of the incinerator. It looks like it used to be some kind of glass ball, but just about big enough to fit in the palm of your hand.
Is that?
Do you know what this is? Mm-hmm. They say if you collect all 7, a dragon will appear and grant you a single wish. Dude, but the dragon balls are golden.
Kidding aside, it's the kind of thing you might see on any big city street corner. Gaze into it, and it will show you a glimpse of the future. Just like that Mina girl who was on that quest to find that one guy.
I feel like I know what he's talking about. If he's making a reference here to anything anyway, but I can't. Yeah, I get what you're trying to say, but who did this particular ball belong to? There's only one person it could be. They should still be in the gym. I better go find that out for sure. Nice! Yeah, I know who it was. We know who it is, dude. Ooh. There's something on the ground in front of the incinerator. Like, it looks like a burnt piece of something. A burnt piece of a shirt, dude. Or jacket. A burnt piece? Like a hunk? Like a hunk of burning love? Bruh. Anyway, this is... It looks like a piece of cloth. And the shape. It's part of a sleeve from a button-up shirt. And now that I look at it, there's definitely blood on the cuff, which means this is all that's left of some of the evidence of some of the evidence the killer destroyed. But there are lots of people here with white button-up shirts. This isn't enough by itself to figure out who the killer is. No, it's not. But let's look at the incinerator. This is the incinerator. It's way in the back part of the trash room. It's a good 30 feet from here to the gate. And it's on right now. Mm-hmm. Do you see the green and yellow buttons next to the mouth of the incinerator?
Yes, indeed.
It's a pretty simple setup. You press the green button to get it going, and the yellow button to turn it off. Yes, indeed. Sooner or later, you'll be cleaning up. You'll be on cleaning duty. So make sure you learn this before you leave. Okay? Huh? Someone turned this incinerator on. Very strange. I'm quite certain it was off the last time I was down here. Perhaps it was the work of a fairy. Hifumi, do you realize what you just said? Huh? The fairy? No. You said the last time you were here, the incinerator was off. Ah, yes. About that, there can be no mistake.
If I've got one thing going for me, it's my memory.
I feel as if...
Yesterday, as soon as I was appointed, I came down to check the place out. It definitely wasn't on then. I haven't been back to the trash room since then. And since I'm the only one who has a key to open the gate...
Most suspicious.
It should be impossible for the incinerator to be on, and yet... So that means someone was able to switch on the incinerator without opening the gate. But... how is that possible? Yes, guys, how is it possible? What do you... Oh, this whole thing is quite strange indeed. When I was last here, the incinerator was off and those glass shards and burnt clothes weren't. What does it all mean, Mr. Naegi? Will you be confessing soon? Why me? Everyone already knows you did it. All the mysteries are being solved one by one. Sounds like he's living out one of his comic book fantasies. So, guys, what do you think of the investigation so far? Any conclusions you've drawn from this? Green button turns on. Yeah. Okay, cool. Right, I'm dipping. Any deductions you'd like to... Any suggestions you'd like to make? Jim. Yes, thank you, did it all along. Yes, we did it. You thought it was Leon who did it, but it was actually me, Dio! I couldn't get along with anyone, JK. Yeah, I'm the one who did it, you know. That wasn't even Naegi, it was actually just me. I killed it, dude. If only there was Dio, man. If only we had stands. Anyways. Hey, Hiro, can I ask you something? No! I gotta get out of here. Gotta get out now. I've had enough. Gotta break free. Hiro, snap out of it. Huh? Makoto, what are you doing here? What? Hey, does this look familiar? Huh? That's my crystal ball. But it's all smashed. What the hell? I only bought it because the guy said it was blessed. He said it was unbreakable. So how did it break? You're an idiot, man. This is why you're held back. What? Was it actually just made of glass and not crystal? Did that guy totally dupe me? He said it belonged to the pillars of history. Genghis Khan, George Washington, Napoleon. He said whoever controlled that crystal ball controlled the world. Was that seriously all BS? Yes, Mel. What is your question? I shall answer for you. Let's put that aside for now. So you can say without a doubt that this belonged to you. Yeah, that's mine for sure. I probably forgot it in the laundry room last night. Someone must have come by and snatched it. You left it in the laundry room? That means anyone could have found it and taken it. How do you leave your... What? Thanks, Hiro. That's all I wanted to know. Sure. By the way, I'm almost afraid to ask, but how much did you pay for that thing? Everything I saved up from fortune telling for 2 full years. Came out to be like $1 million.
This is why you were held back until you're 21, dude.